thank you so much. We're glad to be here today. We want to thank everyone who's tuning in and listening to us around the world. We praise God for what's happening in Columbia, South Carolina on the 12th of March, the year 2017. You can't see it in here, but outside it is snow, magnificent snow like we've never seen in South Carolina. Last week it was 70 degrees. This week we have snow almost on the ground. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
It's falling heavily, but it's not cold enough for it to stick. And some people couldn't make it today. Amen. They said it was a storm alert. But I tell you, I just thank God for the saints who are gathered here today in Jesus' name. Somebody amen. Say amen. Amen. We're excited about the word today because it has a lot to do with the snow. We're here in beautiful downtown Columbia, South Carolina, where there are smiling faces and beautiful places. We want you to know that we welcome you. Won't you get an opportunity to come to the Mecca of all places in the United States, Columbia, South Carolina. And we're going to get right into the word today. We're going to be looking at Genesis 12, verses 1 through 4. And you, of course, know the story. That's the one of Abram leaving home. Let us pray. Oh, God, merciful and mighty, we bless your name today. We pray that you would allow your spirit to fill us from the soles of our feet to the crown of our head. Oh, God, we ask that you would unleash the power of clear thinking by opening our ears and letting the words saturate in our minds that we may receive a revelation unto us given by God. We ask this and every blessing in the name of your Son, Jesus the Christ. Somebody ought to say amen.
Amen.
I'm just so excited about the word today. There are only four verses in the scripture reading from the book of Genesis. And it starts Genesis 12, verses 1 through 4. And this is the King James Version. Now the Lord said unto Abram, get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred and from thy father's house unto the land that I will show thee. And I will make thee a great nation. I will bless thee and make thy name great. And thou shalt be a blessing. And I will bless them that bless thee. And I will curse them that curses thee. And in thee shall all families of the earth be blessed. So Abram departed, as the Lord had spoken unto him, and Lot went with him. Abram was 75 years old when he departed out of Haran. Amen. Verses 1 through 4. We ask that the Lord would add a blessing to his word. Today we will speak from the subject, leaving home to be a blessing. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You know, I want to set the record straight. I was in conversations this week with some of my African-American friends. And they said to me that how can you follow this white man's religion? Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And I said, brother, what do you mean? He said, well, you know, Jesus was white. Abraham was white. Isaac was white. And I said, brother, are you sure? Are you really sure that this is a white man's religion? I said, now you seem to be equipped on the subject of black history. I don't know whether you realize it or not, but recent archaeological discoveries have placed the first man as a coming out of Africa. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
They're saying that man originated in Africa, there are parts near. If that is true, if the first man was a black man, then every man after that man would be a descendant of a black man.
Amen.
And so when I come under this scripture, I'm not bound by race. I'm bound by humanity.
Amen.
And the God that we serve. I don't know whether you have ever stopped to notice this, but when it rains on the black, it rains on the white, it rains on the Jew, It rains on the Gentile. Somehow we seem to share the same circumstance as it relates to heaven. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And so when they said, Father Abraham, I think I too can call him Father Abraham. Yeah. But the lesson today, lest we get astray, is coming from verses 3 and 4. Verses 2 and 3. And it says, and I will make of thee a great nation, and I will bless you and make thy name great. And thou shalt be a blessing, and I will bless them that bless thee. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Leaving home to be a blessing. Sometimes we are stuck at home. Sometimes we can't go to the left or the right because of the fear of leaving home. There's something called a mama's boy, mama's little baby. He never could break away from suckling on mama's breast. And as he grows up to be a youngster, he's hanging around mama's skirt tail. Everything in his world depends on mama. We call that child a mama's boy. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
For that child to come into his own, he has to leave the skirt tail of mama and go out and venture into the world. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
I want you to know that every animal on the face of the earth, there's this type of bond where the animal has a choice when it comes of age to leave home. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
It is almost unnatural to stay in thy father's house too long.
Amen.
There can only be one head of a house.
Yeah.
I remember as my son grew into a teenager, he became a little confused about who was the head of the house.
Yeah.
As his voice deepened and became more like mine, as his shoulders broadened and became more like mine, as his height lengthened and became more like mine, it seemed that he began to think that he should be like me. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
When I speak, my voice thunders through my house. And lo and behold, when he spoke, his voice began to thunder through the house. And he began to feel that he had some rights and privileges because he was a lot like me. But we have to understand that to rule does not come from your size, your height, or your voice. To rule a household comes from your genetic predisposition and your position in the family. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You can't come up as a child and rule the parents. The parents rule the child. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
I want you to know today that that's what's wrong with the world. There are a lot of people who have the size of a parent. They have the voice of a parent. They even have the height of a parent. But they do not have the wisdom, the wealth, or the handling of responsibility like a parent. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Someone has to appoint you head of the house. I am saying to my children and to my members, God has to appoint the head of the house. Some of you came up in mama's church or daddy's church, and you began to sit right behind mama and daddy. And you wanted to inherit all that daddy and mama had earned in the house of God. But the Bible says when God speaks for you to leave this place and go out on your own to a place that God will show you and that he will make your extension a great nation. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You know, a lot of times we read these stories as applied to just Abram and not how they apply to us. I'm sure when Abram came to time to leave his father's house, to leave his kindred, to leave their land, to leave their cattle, to leave their flock. Oh, he looked out into the great expanse over the horizon and saw nothing. And he looked at all that his fathers and his kindred had. He said, would I be a fool to choose nothing over everything? But when God speaks to you, when God makes a promise to you, when God gives you clear direction, oh, you got to move. You've got to leave your home to be a blessing. Some would say, well, staying around the house, you're a blessing to the family. Staying around the house, you're a blessing to your kindred. Oh, but I say to you that God has a bigger plan for all of us. Even the prodigal son had to leave home to be a blessing.
Yes.
Oh, I know he went through trials and tribulation. I know he was down in the hog trough eating. But some say all things work together for good for them that love the Lord. So even on his sojourn away from home, there were lessons to be had. There were lessons to be learned. There were experiences to be charted. And when he had come to his full knowledge of himself, he said, oh, in my father's house, even the servants are doing better. And so he returned home to his father's house, but in a new disposition, with a new understanding. Now, I love this because it's tied into our gospel reading today. When Jesus told Nicodemus that a man has to be born again.
Yes.
That a man has to be born of the water and of the spirit.
Amen.
So even in the book of Genesis, we're seeing that a child has to be born again, has to leave his mother and father and be born again, born out of a new set of experiences, born out of new circumstances, born out of independence. But when God makes you a promise, you can leave home and not worry about it. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You can leave home with the blessings that God has already prepared for you. Now let's look at the partnership that God has. God is in partnership with parents.
Yes.
God is in partnership with teachers.
Yes.
God is in partnership with the kindred.
Yes.
So God is in partnership with those who prepare you to leave home.
Yes.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
So God's got your back,
yes,
and he's got all that's ahead of you. But you got to leave home in order to be a blessing. Now, Abraham was given a promise by Almighty God. Abraham was promised that he would make him and his seed a great nation.
Yes.
And thou shalt be a blessing to everyone that you meet.
Yes.
I'm telling you that the nuclear physicists of tomorrow.
Yes.
I'm telling you that the agriculturalists of tomorrow.
Yes.
I'm telling you that the teacher of tomorrow is one that left home.
Amen.
The one that left home for college. One that left home for trade school.
Yes.
One that left home to be a blessing.
Yes.
Said to be blessed, but to be a blessing.
Amen.
Now, when Abraham left home, he had no way of knowing who would provide. He could only take the promise of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, some of these children, when they leave home, they can't pay for college. They can't pay for trade school. They can't pay for anything. But the God that I serve is in partnership with the parents.
Yes.
The God that I serve is in partnership with Pell. Somebody said, well, who's Pell? Well, Pell's the first name. Grant is the last name. God has already made a provision for you to leave home.
Yes.
Well, why does he want you to leave home? He wants you to go through a rebirth. Let me give you an example. A caterpillar cannot become a butterfly unless it's reborn. Come on, somebody.
Yes.
Unless it goes into the cocoon and goes through a transformation. Well, we go through the transformation of circumstance, the transformation of disposition, the transformation of being in a different place at a different time with a different set of circumstances. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
But God said, leave home and I will bless you so that you might be a blessing.
Yes.
You know, the prodigal son had one problem. He left home selfishly.
Yes.
He left home to bless only himself. He left home and took all that was promised to him to squander. But when Abraham left, he left in partnership with God. Now somebody have to ask, well, how did he come to be a partner with God? Well, all these that are homeless, all these that are poor, broke, all these that can't feed themselves, they left home without having a partner.
Yes.
They left home without being in partnership with the one who sent them.
Yes.
You can't make it without God. You can't be anything without God. God will feed you. He will nurture you. He will take care of you.
Yes.
But you gotta be in partnership. So when you leave home under the prayers and watchful eye of your mother and father, in order to be a blessing, you've got to replicate what they've already done.
Yes.
You've got to find a church to go to.
Yes.
Somebody asked me, said, well, what's so good about church? I tell anybody who's homeless, who's broke, who's about to be put out of their house, who don't have a place or anything to eat, I tell, are you a member of a church?
Yes.
Because I seem to notice that when I go around a church, there's a parking lot.
Yes.
And most of the people in the church got cars.
Yes.
But now if I go to the homeless mission, I see that most of the people are walking. Somebody else say amen.
Amen.
I'm trying to draw a correlation here.
Yes.
I notice that the people who go to church are the ones who go out to eat.
Yes.
But I notice the ones who don't go to church are eating not as a family, but eating like the prodigal son.
Yes.
God said, you got to leave home to be a blessing.
Yes.
To be blessed and to be a blessing. But you got to leave home like Abraham left home, with the clear instructions and directions from God. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
I'm excited about this scripture.
Yes.
Somebody doesn't like it. They say, well, Father Abraham, I'm black. Father Abraham was a Jew. I just explained to you, it's not where you're coming from,
yes,
but where you're going.
Yes.
Now, when Jesus came into the world, he adopted us into the family of God.
Yes.
He reconciled us. It's not where we came from, but where we're going. Now, Jesus said, now, how can I explain to you heavenly things? Come on, I'm over in John. John 3, 1 to 17. How can I explain to you heavenly things? How can I explain to you spiritual things when you can't even understand the things that you are seeing?
Yes.
Oh, when he struck a conversation with Nicodemus, he said, Nicodemus, you should know better. You've been on the council, Sanhedrin council. You're one of the rulers of the Jews. You're supposed to know the word. Then how can you question me if you're to know these things? Unless a man be born again, he cannot enter the kingdom of heaven.
Yes.
I'm telling everybody who's homeless, you need to be born again.
Yes.
I'm telling everybody who's suffering, even those in the hospital,
yes,
even those who are sick,
yes,
you need to be born again.
Yes.
Born of the Spirit,
yes,
and born of water. Now, in the Jewish tradition, there were 10 places in the temple where you could bathe or be washed or be baptized,
yes,
be made clean and be made whole. And each one of the 10 places, there are 40 baths. Come on,
yes,
somebody. In the temple itself, there were 400 baths. So being born again of the water, being washed, being baptized, being ritually made clean was important. You got to clean your mind. You got to clean your attitude. You got to clean your disposition. You've got to clean your way. So God is saying you've got to leave the old self and become the new self,
yes,
in Christ,
yes,
that you might be blessed and be a blessing to someone.
Yes.
Do you know the joy of the Lord is our strength? I mean, when adversaries come, when the devourer comes, it is the joy of the Lord that enables us to stand. When our adversaries come, when our bills come, when our difficult circumstances come, when cancer knocks on the door, it is the joy of the Lord that's our strength.
Yes.
But how can you have joy if you don't know the Lord? You've got to leave the mother's skirt tail and come to know the Lord for yourself. Now, when you're in mama's house, under mama's prayers, under daddy's provision, you can rely on how they know the Lord. Come on, somebody. But when you leave home, the blessing that you will be under are the prayers of your own. Sometimes mama prayers will reach out just for so long as to try to protect you from the harshest things of life. But you can't rely on the prayers of mama. You've got to come to the full knowledge of Jesus Christ yourself.
Yes.
The third verse says, "And I will bless them that bless you, and I will curse them that curses you. And in thee shall all families on earth be blessed."
Yes.
Hallelujah. They asked me about the homeless mission. They asked me about the places that are for unwed mothers. They said, "Well, why do you Christians spend your time trying to help orphans and widows, the women who have been abused by domestic violence? Why do you spend your time over at the prisons with the juveniles who have been incarcerated?"
Yes.
Well, because we are the seed of Abraham.
Yes, we are.
We are blessed to be a blessing.
Yes.
We are on the outside looking on the inside to see where the blessing is needed so that we can be there.
Yes.
I mentioned the snow that's falling outside. And some said they couldn't make it. But others said, "How can I not make it? Because I have been blessed. I've got to go and bless God." Somebody say amen. I've got to sit in his presence. I've got to give him glory. I've got to lift up his name so that when I'm filled with the very nature of the one who made everything, I will become a blessing to others. I'll be able to go rain, sleet, snow, or shine to the prisons and be a blessing. I will be able to go to the hospitals. I'll be able to go to the nursing homes and be a blessing. I will be in the house of God, no matter what the weather, to be a blessing. And so then while I am there making preparations to go out into the world, the Lord Jesus will fill me. Fill me up that I might be a blessing. So many of us are hungry, have a sense of emptiness, clinging on to the things of this world. We have been blessed so mightily. We have the cars, but yet we have a hunger. We have the houses, but yet we have a hunger. We have every convenience and comfort that this world will allow, and yet we are restless. Well, we need to leave home because we have been blessed to be a blessing.
Yes.
There's a mission field in Uganda, in Kenya, in Burundi. There's a mission field in Nigeria, in India, in Asia. There's a mission field that's waiting on you to come, seed of Abraham, to be a blessing.
Yes.
And what shall you bless the people with? Shall you bless them as you've been blessed? Yes, but what was your blessing? Was it your material things? No. It was the word of God.
Yes.
It was a relationship with God. It was obedience to God.
Yes.
Obedience is better than sacrifice.
Yes.
So when you obey God and the teachings of Jesus Christ, the last thing he said was go. Leave home. Leave home and go. teaching them, baptizing them, all the things that I've taught you, be a blessing.
Yes.
You know, I've been saying leave. And somebody wants to know where that word leave come from. And some will research it in the Greek. Some will try to find some clarification in Latin. But I'm going to find an explanation of this word leave in the things that God created.
Yes.
I want you to know that in the Garden of Eden that we discussed last week were two trees.
Yes,
sir. One was a tree of eternal life.
Yes.
The other was a tree of knowledge of good and evil. And when Adam and Eve were like a leaf, they had to leave the garden.
Yes,
just like leaves fall off the tree. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And so the word leave comes from the word leaf. When the leaves leave the tree and come and are reborn, recycled, and become nurturing to the kingdom of God. You've got to leave the tree and come on out and be a part of the branch. Come on out and start a new generation.
Yes.
My brothers and sisters, maybe it's time for you to make up your mind to leave what you're in and follow the directions of God to be a blessing to all the others who are waiting. We're calling you to the mission field.
Yes.
We're calling you into this house.
Yes.
Leave your present circumstance and come into the house of God. Leave the homeless mission. Leave the domestic violence shelter and come unto Him who's able to change everything.
Yes.
Let us stand. We close inviting each one of you to leave home, to leave the place of comfort, and hear the voice of God directing you to a new beginning, directing you to drop all the things that you have that's holding you back, the weights that so easily beset us, and come unto Him, the one who has everything.
Yes.
O God, merciful and mighty, we ask you to give us the courage to leave our place.